वेलकम टू सेंटर फॉर ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन उत्तर प्रदेश राजस्थान ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी. फ्रेंड्स, इन द सीरीज ऑफ प्रोडक्शन मैनेजमेंट नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डील विद एन मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन द प्रोडक्शन मैनेजमेंट दैट इज नोन एज इन्वेंट्री कंट्रोल सिस्टम. एज यू ऑल नो दैट प्रोडक्शन इज अ वेरी वाइटल एलिमेंट फॉर एनी बिजनेस. एज यू कैन सी दैट फॉर बिजनेस फोर कॉम्पोनेंट्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. First is finance, from where you are going to get the money. The second one is human resource, because these are the people who are going to convert the raw material into finished good. Then you have got production, that means that you have to take certain things, you have to produce certain things, and after production this requires marketing. So marketing is the fourth aspect for any system. So this is a chain for any management system which one has to follow. Some management personalities used to say that finance is the most and vital element for any system, while some says that human resource management is important. Some says that marketing is an important, because without marketing you can create a product but you cannot create the demand in the market. But overall the nucleus of the system depends upon the production, because if you have got a product, unless and until you don't have got any product, you cannot market it. If you have got finance, that you have to think that what you are going to produce. You have got the manpower, but what you are going to make. So the question, big question over here is this, that the product is very important, because product lies in the center. For this product you required finance, for construction of this product you required human resource management, and for this product you are going to market. So the production management is one of the core for all the managerial activity and for all the production unit. So here we are going to deal with the inventory. In simple terms, inventory is the raw material. That means something which we used to take for the processing activity, and we are going to create some finished good. So let's see over here. An inventory control system is a tool that maintains live records of inventory quantities, locations and other stocks specification of the business across its supply chain. Means here we are going to take the database and we are going to maintain that database for the welfare of the organization. That means that from where you are going to get the inventory, how much inventory you are going to require, and how it is being processed. At what time you are again going to reorder that inventory is very important over here. Now this is a tool also support business owners to forecast optimum inventory levels with the data driven insight. Means whenever you have to take the optimum level, it means that you are going to take each and every aspect in the business, reducing the wastages. So here we used to say that it is an optimum driven database system. So inventory system used to come over here. It enables them to avoid shortage and minimize wastage from the excess inventories. Means whatever we need, we are going to order it, and accordingly we are going to use it for our system. So inventory control system is somewhat backbone for any organization when it comes to production management. Now, types of inventory control system. There are three types of inventory control system. First is periodic inventory system. Periodic inventory system means whenever we are going to produce certain things which are based on seasonal or cyclical conditions, we need periodic inventory system. Means every 6 months or every quarter we have to give orders for that raw material, and it is going to be there on the time. So whenever we are going to distribute, and we used to give the orders on the basis of quarterly, half yearly, monthly basis, yearly basis, we say that is a periodic inventory system. Then perpetual inventory system. Perpetual inventory system means that whenever there is reduction in the inventory, we are, as soon as there is a reduction in the inventory, we used to give the order. Means when there is a downfall in the inventory, we have to reorder the inventory. Means the process must be maintained so that an organization must not shortfall of the inventory. So here perpetual inventory system is being taken into consideration.
The third one is barcode inventory system. With the help of technology, now it is very easy for any organization to access that how much inventory it has got. Because now they used to make a barcode in the finished good. So by the help of the barcode, a manager used to know that how many product is being produced, and on the basis of demand, that how much product is in the market. And according to demand, we used to create the product, and for this product, we required the inventory. Therefore, by the help of barcode, we used to order and reorder our inventory as per the need. So in the periodic, we used to order it into monthly, quarterly, annually system. In the perpetual, whenever there is a need, we used to order it. And in the barcode system, when we used to see that there is a demand for the product, and accordingly we increase or decrease the level of inventory required. Now, how does inventory control system works? So it is a big system. As you know, that inventory control system has certain things. The first is a material requirement. What type of material is required? For example, when you are going to construct a house, you required bricks, you required stone, you required sand, you required tiles, you required cement. So as far apart from manpower. So these are the common components for any construction, right? So the first thing is this, that the material is being required. And on the basis of the quality of the material and the handling of the material, you are going to order it. Second one is inventory valuation. As you all know, that taking an example of construction of a house, the cost of cement is more than the cost of sand. And the brick is somewhat of average cost. So here, whenever we are going to buy the product, inventory valuation is very important. The product which has got the higher value must be taken care of more than the product which is of less quality or less cost. Then barcode tagging. Again, I have told you with the invent of technology, barcoding is there. So by the help of barcoding, we used to code the product, and this helps in the inventory system that the output is this much, so required this much of product. Then purchase history. At what time you have purchased the thing, and what is this expiry date, or how much time is being required to process the raw material into finished good. So this can be easily understood by the help of purchase history. Then reordering point. Reordering point means every organization maintains a common level that is known as the point at which they are going to reorder the quantity so that there is no shortfall of the inventory. So that point is known as the reorder point. For example, if you are constructing a house and you are having two laborers and two skilled employees, and per day you are going to have 400 bricks to be used. So automatically for the next day, if you have got 200 bricks, so automatically two laborers are going to be of no use. So every day you have to maintain 400 bricks minimum. So at least you have to order 500 bricks whenever there is a shortage of the brick. So 500 over here is the reordering point. Then importance of inventory system. As I have told you, that inventory system is very important because it is somewhat the backbone of the production system. Because for any production unit or for any product, inventory is being required, and that too, that inventory must have a proper standard quality, because that quality is going to help to get the best product in the market. First one is reduced ordering cost. Means when you have a proper inventory system working in an organization, automatically your ordering cost used to reduce. As you all know, that when our product is going to be used or utilized in the market, you require less space for the storage of the product. And apart from this, you also know that when the cost of the product is going to high or low, sometimes the raw material cost increases in the market. At that time, if you maintain a proper order or a proper label, you don't have to order it. So whenever there is a fall in the cost of inventory, you have to order it. And when there is a rise, you must have a proper storage so that your cost is not going to be affected. Effective working capital management. As I have told you, that working capital is a capital by which you are going to carry all the business activity. So by the help of proper inventory management system, one can easily understand and use his budget for the proper allocation of the inventory. At what time, what inventory is going to be bought and how it is going to be used with a minimum care, this can easily be done by the help of proper inventory management system. Then efficient production. As I have told you that for any production, inventory is very important because it is a system where input of inventory is being done and it is being processed so that the final product is being given out. And this product is the product which is being used by the customers. So there must be an efficient production system that according to the demand, you have a proper supply system. Then quantity discounts in procurement means whenever you are going to make the product, it must be taken into care that the more the product is being created, the less the cost it requires. Because whenever you are going to buy the product or you are going to buy the inventory in bulk, automatically the cost used to reduce. So here, by the help of proper inventory system, there is a quantity discounts which is being taken into consideration. Then last one, more satisfied customers. As you all know that when we talk about a good product, there must be a good raw material because raw material is the base of every product. Input, output depends upon the processes. So in this process, you have human resource. So automatically, when the good product is being input over here, then the process must be properly done by the workers and accordingly, the best product is going to be there. So when the best product is in the market, automatically all over the customer who are working, who are using that product must be satisfied. And in marketing, there's a term that is known as customer delight that is being achieved by the customer when they are going to get the product which is being desired by them. So these are some of the points which says that why we used to need the inventory management system. Then inventory control versus inventory management. As you all know, that control system is being done by the controller, coordinator and systems of the managers, and management is a big process which has been taken into account. Here we are going to see this topic into three parts, that is the scope, goal and action. The first one is inventory control management scope. Inventory control is mainly concerned with monitoring and control of existing items in the warehouse. Means when we talk about inventory control system, we only talk about the raw material which is being there in the warehouse. Okay, while when we talk about inventory management, it may involve the management of inventory throughout the supply chain like procurement, production and distribution. Means when it comes to management, it is a bigger activity from where we are going to buy the product, how we are going to maintain our supply chain in management and where we are going to supply the product. Everything used to come over in the inventory management system. Then goals. When we talk about the goal, inventory control, it makes sure that the existing inventory system are in good condition and in the right quantity. Means when we talk about the inventory control system, we talk about the right type of product, the right level of the product, means when we are going to order it, it must have a proper maintaining system. It must have that system which doesn't have a shortfall of the inventory. The cost of the product must be properly maintained. So here it deals with a narrow or a specific activity. When we talk about inventory management looks after all end-to-end operations to ensure production cycles, have the required materials at the right time and that the order are delivered on time. Means here when we talk about inventory management system, we talk about that the orders which are being given over there must carries a proper time system. Means the time at which our raw material is going to be in the production unit and the processing system and the time at which it will be in the market. So inventory management system deals with all the activity, means from procuring of the raw material to the finished good and reaching that finished good to the market. Then the last one is actions. Functions of inventory control system includes storing inventory and managing activities such as transportation and testing. When we talk about inventory control system, it is all about procuring of the raw material, testing of the raw material and transportation of the raw material within the unit. From, for example, you have got three units, A, B, C. So, in the machine A, the work is going to be done. After that, B is going to be taken and C is going to be taken. So, there must be a proper transportation system so that there is no downfall in the system. When we talk about inventory management, ensuring that the stored items are in good conditions, checking their expiry, spoilage, etc., forecasting the demand and making strategies accordingly. Here, it is a big activity. Here, we used to see that the product is in good shape. It must be sent to the market before the expiry date. It must be seen that there must be reduction of wastage. There is no spoilage of the raw material. So, all this activity comes into inventory management system. So, inventory control system works in a very narrow form, while inventory management system is a big form where management activity is being done from procuring of the good to the reaching of the final product to the market. Now, types of inventory control system. The first one is ABC. ABC says that it is an activity-based costing or always best control. So here it is an inventory system which we used to follow when we used to construct in a heavy or in a big business. Then you have got JIT, just in time management system, means whatever you required, that inventory is being kept into the consideration. Then you have got VED, vital, essential, desirable. So here the raw material is being kept into three part. Vital means which is very important. Essential means it is important but it has got an alternate. And desirable means it is important but it can be taken for a month or 2 months to be replaced. So here VED is being taken into consideration. Then the last one is economic order quantity. Economic order quantity says that you have got to see that at what cost you are going to reorder that product, and the cost of the product must be low so that your final product has a less cost and you are going to achieve the good profit over the business. So economic order quantity is somewhere which we deal about the business. I hope you have understood about the inventory system. This is the most important act. It is the crux of all the production system. Thank you.